Angular version 16 was released. And Angular version 16, whilst giving us many nice features, gives us one super important, huge new feature. It gives us signals. Now, as mentioned, that's not the only new feature. Attached, you find a link to the official release blog post where all those new features are listed and explained. For example, Angular 16 also allows us to mark inputs as required, leading to errors if you accidentally forgot to pass a value to some component input. But signals are the big new thing, and Angular 16 adds them as a developer preview, which means that the feature is not finished yet, more features might be added, and patterns and best practices are yet to evolve. So signals are basically added to Angular in the same way as standalone components were added in Angular 14. Those were also added as a developer preview, and even now that they're stable, they're fully optional, and they can also be combined with module-based components. And with signals, it will basically be the same. Currently, they're in developer preview, and once they're finished, probably with Angular 17, you will be able to fully use them, but they will also be totally optional. You don't have to relearn Angular, you don't have to rewrite your code. Signals are optional and can simply be added to existing apps. But what are these signals about in the first place? Well, signals in the end give you an alternative way of detecting changes in Angular. Right now, without signals, Angular basically handles change detection for you. It, for example, understands that you got some click listeners, it then watches the methods that are being executed as those clicks occur, and it understands that in those methods, data gets changed, properties of this component class. Angular then also evaluates your UI and finds out where this data is being used so that it can update those parts of the UI. The big advantage of this current change detection system, therefore, is that it's fully automatic and you don't have to do anything, which of course sounds perfect. The downside is that the performance is impacted by this automatic watching and this automatic algorithm, which is executed all the time, and the Angular bundle size is also a bit bigger than it needs to be because it has to include all this change detection code. Signals give you an alternative way of handling changes and change detection. With signals, which can but don't have to be used in standalone components, you create values by calling the signal function, which is provided by Angular. It's imported from Angular Core. This signal function creates a signal object, and this object basically acts as a wrapper around your data. And signals can wrap any kind of data. Numbers, strings, booleans, objects, and of course also arrays. They can really wrap any kind of data. In this case here, a number. Signals then are updated by calling special update methods like set, mutate, or update. Now the differences in the end are that update gets a function that yields the new value based on the current value. Mutate can be used by updating an old value that's provided automatically by Angular, just as it's the case with update. By mutating that old value, instead of returning a new value, that's the difference between mutate and update. Update returns a new value, mutate mutates an existing value, in this case an existing array. And alternatively, you could also simply call set to set a new value. If that new value depends on an old value and you don't want to use update, which would be a great alternative, you could simply call this old value as a function to derive the overall new value. And that's another special thing about signals. You don't just update them in a different way by calling these special updating methods, but you also read them. You get access to the values stored by the signals by executing them as functions, either here in your TypeScript code like this, or in your template like this for counter and actions. So signal values are accessed by calling those signals as functions in the places where you want to read them. And that's the whole idea behind signals. Now, as you can clearly see, signals therefore mean a bit more work for you, the developer, because there is no automatic change detection anymore. Instead, you have to tell Angular by calling set, mutate, or update whenever a value changes. And you also have to tell Angular where that signal data is being used by executing that signal as a function. For example, here in this template. But the huge advantage of this signals feature is that you got more control about when change detection runs, and you therefore can achieve a better application performance and a smaller application bundle. Though this will really only be true once more signal features are added in the future, because then you will indeed be able to switch to a signal-only Angular app, which gets rid of all that automatic change detection code, which is included in the bundle otherwise. But that's why this signals feature exists. It can lead to a better performance, a smaller bundle size, and in some way also to more control over when the UI updates for you, the developer. Now, in my Angular course, I already added a new section on signals where I explain this new feature in greater depth and by taking a closer look at it. And especially in the future, probably with Angular 17, once this feature is complete, you could say, this could give us an exciting alternative way of building Angular applications, which is not totally different compared to how we're building those applications today, but which might be a bit leaner and maybe also a bit easier to understand for developers.